Photographers rely on expensive equipment to create unique visual effects in their work, sometimes spending thousands on camera bodies, lenses and filters to achieve that professional look. But filmmakers have been putting the same amount of effort into their smartphone camera experiences to ensure that you can get a professional finish in your shots. Depth of field or bokeh are always popular effects, which some of the latest smartphones have tried to recreate as accurately as possible, despite their tiny lenses. Here are a few great examples of phones that produce the best results. Samsung's new top dog sports a 13 megapixel snapper that comes with a selective focus mode built in. Set the camera into this mode, hold the phone steady and snap a shot where you have the subject in the foreground and another in the background. The S5 actually takes multiple shots and lets you choose to save pictures with near focus, far focus or pan focus, which is where the whole image is sharp. You can go in and tweak the focal point of your shot after the fact too. Nokia's refocus app works across all of its Windows Phone 8 handsets, but for the best results, there's no other choice than the Lumia 1020. With its superior lens and 41 megapixel sensor, it produces the best looking shots of the bunch. Simply move the phone until your foreground subject is in focus and then press the shutter. Like the Samsung, the refocus app compiles several shots, letting you tap to focus anywhere in the frame and even add a little color pop. The One M8's unique duo camera means that this is the only phone in the lineup that can offer background defocus in a single snap. Essentially, it's the fastest of the five. Take a photo, head into the gallery, choose Edit, and then tap U-Focus. You can then tap anywhere to add a little lens blur to highlight a subject. There's a massive 20.7 megapixel camera on the back of Sony's Xperia Z2, and it's pretty awesome. One of the many modes it boasts is called background defocus and, as you expect, it lets you tweak the background blur on your images. You have to choose the mode before you take the snap and you can only add the blur once you've taken it. It then saves the blurred image to your gallery, so make sure you're happy before you hit save. Whilst it's a little hit and miss, background defocus on the Z2 lets you vary the amount and type of blur from lens blur to horizontal or vertical motion blur. Google recently updated the standard camera app for Android, and on the majority of devices you should be able to access the lens blur feature by selecting it from the swipe out menu on the left side of the camera UI. When taking a snap, press the shutter and then slowly raise the phone up, keeping the foreground subject centered. You'll then get a progress bar as your phone processes the image. Then you can browse your gallery and change the amount of blur and focus point should you want to. Found this video helpful? If you did, please like, subscribe and drop any comments down below. Don't forget to check out Recombu.com and thanks for watching. You can quickly toggle settings such as Bluetooth and Wi-Fi on or off by flicking from the top of your screen, revealing your notifications bar, and then tapping the Quick Settings tab. Shift the phone and using the gyroscope, you'll see all that depth information comes to life. Look around what's in the foreground and hide or reveal background. Thanks to the extra image data the Lumia 1020's camera captures, it can iron out a multitude of photographic sins such as camera shake, image blur, and noise. What's